Hey everybody, sPidA here, the Coming Soon Podcast, of course, coming to you live from San Antonio, Texas. I am here with Michael Reid Mackay. Sir, how are you doing today?
I'm pretty good, thank you very much.
Man, as far as here in San Antonio, is this your first time coming to the city?
Second time in San Antonio.
Okay.
Yes.
And of course, I mean, you're here in business, but have you ever been here on vacation?
No, just that one time I did another convention here in San Antonio.
Okay, but it was, I mean, you didn't get to see the city as far as travel. Look at the
I did the river walk.
Okay,
yeah.
Well, that counts, you know, that's something.
Yeah.
Now, of course, I mean, because of what's going on, I can't ask a lot of detailed questions, of course. But when it comes to yourself, I mean, growing up, what was it? Some of the things that you were into as far as an art, like a theater? Were you involved in photography or anything like that?
Well, for the longest time, I wanted to be a chef.
Oh, nice.
And then I got into theater. Theater, when I hit the stage, I knew that's what I wanted to do.
You were like, I don't want to cook, I
want to... Yeah, so I still like to cook, but I decided I wanted to be an actor.
Okay.
So I went to actor school in New York City in the early 70s after I graduated. Worked here and graduated. And I didn't get accepted back. It was a two-year program, And the reason why I had to go back and find out why.
Right.
And so when the guy talked to me, he said, well, you're very small. And he said, I don't think the acting business is for you. He said, maybe you should look into the retail business. And he was, to me, like when I got older, I thought he was projecting his failures onto me or something. So, being young at the time, I was angry, but I was also, no one's going to tell me what I want.
Right.
Because I wanted, that was my passion.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
So I listened to him and everything, and went through a little depression, but just got over it. And I continued on with theater, and then in the 80s, I was working a regular job, and it was like, I saw a friend of mine saw an ad in Variety. They wanted someone very small. Then to play this mummy character. I said, you should go for that. And I did. And when I got to Sony Studios, usually you don't go rent to see.
Right.
You go, audition. He just had me walk across the floor. Then he said, now walk across the floor again, but this time do something with your hands and drag your foot.
Oh, man, okay.
And so when I'm doing that, he's arguing with this other person there.
Yeah.
And this, as far as I'm concerned, you got the part. That's just argument. I got a call at that job I was doing. Everyone said, congratulations. This is my little day. I said, yeah. And she said, congratulations. She said, you got the part of the mummy in the Monster Squad. And it was my first professional job. And I was kind of busy. I was kind of taken back. I said, I'm not a screen actor. She goes, I'm not. It's just, don't worry.
Yeah.
And she said, again, congratulations. I hung up the phone for my friend said, she's standing next to me. She said, what? And I said, I'm in a movie. And that was my first professional job, and that's how I fell into doing creature films.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you see, and a lot of times, I mean, for me, a lot of the actors, when they first start off, they do horror movies. I mean, of course, whether they're low budget or just horror, like indie horror films, but that's where you get your footsteps, and then, of course, you know, a lot of them move on and do other films. For yourself, well, were you kind of afraid that you'd get a typecast when you made that movie?
I wasn't, because first of all, it's like, I never dreamed in my life that I'd ever do like horror films, ever. And I just kind of like fell into it. But I did other stuff, and I was still in theater, and it just became like sometimes I had auditions, sometimes I wouldn't. They'd just say, you need a little guy, use Michael Reid Mackay.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I just like whatever.
And of course, I mean, it was more of a character, because of course you didn't have you didn't say anything. I mean, it wasn't like a voice acting film, right? I mean, when you portrayed him, was it all just from your own personal?
Well, it's interesting, because one of the people that came through here said something that's like, most of your films, you don't say anything. I said, true.
Yeah.
I said, but I've done other things where I've spoken.
Right.
You know? But I said, you know, it's just like the body movements, the way I just kind of
Yeah.
And I could do those things, and I just like cherish that. And it's like, what they said was going to be my failure was truly my success.
No. No, you see, and luckily, I mean, of course, you got that part. You know, after that, I mean, a lot of things open up after that.
Yes. Things just like falls because a lot of things opened up.
Yeah.
It was pretty amazing. I can't believe it myself.
No, for sure, because I've seen just about every movie you've been in. At Pupil was one of them, and of course, it kind of goes on a different direction. I mean, it was a lot of, for me, I mean, I enjoyed the film. It was a lot of, it was like a mental, like, it got me thinking on a lot of things, and, you know, it kind of went that way. But, I mean, what were your thoughts on that movie? Like, after you were done, were you like, okay, that's what I expected?
When I saw it, it's kind of like, yeah, it's like, because, like, I always listen to the director's, like, some were, like, very specific. He said, I just want you to, okay, he says, you're supposed to be a concentration camp. Right. He said, think of gas, being gas, he said, you're actually being shot. And he said, just like, look to the camera, and I have a lot of things on my eyes that freak people out. And it's like, oh!
You're not done.
And so, yeah, so when I did that, he said, perfect. He said, yeah, do that again. He said, we're doing it slower.
Man, that's perfect. That's great, though, man.
And after I do something like that, I feel really good when I see it, because it's kind of like, I just put my heart and soul into it. And I just,
yeah.
If I have to scream, I don't just scream. I scream. I scream.
Yeah. No, yeah, you see, and of course, I mean, you're having fun with all these, man. So, I mean, when it comes to acting school, did a lot of that help get you ready, or were you kind of like, man, you know what, did you add your own twist into everything?
I put my own twist on everything, and, you know, of course, I pulled from the acting school.
Oh, yeah.
But no, no one's going to tell me I'm going to do something else. It's like, no way.
Yeah.
But yeah, when I do horror films, I just put everything I got into it. Someone said it's kind of like a little guy being like 12 foot tall.
Yeah.
That's how I feel. That's how I felt when I did Insidious.
Yeah.
I felt 12 foot tall.
Oh yeah, you see in the film, I mean, you look 12 foot tall. I'm not gonna lie, you know, you play a big character, man. I mean, you definitely put yourself out there, and I mean, you definitely bring them to life, I'll put it that way. So, I mean, of course, you're doing a great job, so we definitely appreciate that. When it comes to, as far as, because there's things we can't talk about, of course, but looking forward to seeing what's next. I mean, as far as events like this, are you just enjoying them, taking them for what they are? You see, and I'm actually getting into a lot of voice acting myself. I'm having fun with it, and that's basically my mindset going into it. I'm not like I'm gonna be this guy or that guy, but I want to have fun. And if it takes me somewhere, great. If it doesn't, then I'll just stick with my podcast. So I'm good.
There you go. Perfect attitude.
No, for sure. You know, and of course, I'm at that state in life where this is my retirement job. I have a part-time job that I do. But I'm enjoying this. So, of course, I'm going to keep traveling. I'm going to keep, as long as you guys permit me, I'm going to be interviewing you guys, having fun with it. But I wish you the best. Thank you.
And I just wanted to say that I've retired too. They say, actors never retire.
Oh, yeah.
And so, like, I always look forward to these conventions, talk to people like you, and the energy, the positiveness is great.
Oh, yeah, you see, because, I mean, you're full of life, man. I mean, I'm talking to you, and I know there's a lot more coming out of you, so you are retired, but we'll see. You know, the sky's the limit, so we'll see if anything else comes out of this. Appreciate you, man.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Everybody out there, of course, this is sPidA, the Coming Soon Podcast. Till next time, follow up.